Good afternoon, everybody. Welcome to the Five Water Chat Studio right here in New Orleans. We're live on a beautiful day. I'm Johnny Mastro. This is the Blues Vortex. We got a beautiful show for you. Special guest, Mr. John Foles, sitting in with the band. And we got Mr. J.D. Hill, and the jammer's going to come up and blow your mind. So everybody, kick back. Enjoy yourself. Welcome to the Blues Vortex. Let's have some fun. Come on, buddy. We're gonna start out with one of our songs right here. This is the thing we're gonna try on. It's a new one called One More Time. Thank you. I saw you at your wedding gown. The air was heavy, sun was going down. Baby, one more time. Baby, one more time. Call me for you, baby. Baby, one more time.
I'm out of it, you know.
Do one more before we have our special first musical guest take over. You're looking at him already right there on the guitar, but we're going to try this thing. This is a thing called One Day. We did this about 5 or 6 years ago, so we'll see if we can find the groove, fellas. Same key, huh? Thank you. ain't gonna hold your hand. So one day I got to slip up, baby. Yeah, I got to be a evil man. Transition now to our first guest, but I want to tell you on our house band tonight. On the bass, Mr. Dean Zuccaro, everybody. That's Dean Zuccaro, straight out of the French Quarter via New York City. On the drums, I got Mr. Terry Scott Jr. on the drums, everybody. How about it for him? Yeah. And now what's going to happen now, we're going to end this song, but we got our special guest, one of the finest guitar players you can find anywhere. Mr. John Fole is with us. He's got a new record out. And so we're going to have to do some of the songs so you can check it out. So, everybody, right on. All right. Yeah, you can clap.
Clap it on. All right. Johnny.
You got it. So, everybody, we're going to bring him up. He's filling in today on the guitar anyway. But this is the man we watched for many years. And, you know, he does his own thing, but he's played with a lot of great people. We can talk about that later. But let's just get into some music, everybody. This is Mr. John Fole.
Thank you. side love, baby, ain't my fault. I keep on straight on my toes, baby, digging in deep, and I ain't let go. So look out, mama, look out. I'm coming to you right now. One thing on my mind, baby, I can't wait to get my hands on. Baby, I can't wait to get my hands on. Told me there was just weed. I used to wonder why nothing fazed me, as some unseen eyes light my way. Must be tired of shining in each. You must be tired of shining down on me. I knew never go blind. It makes me wonder what nothing pays. Black-eyed angel sliding my way.
Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. John Fole has got a new record out. You're doing some of your songs, right, Johnny?
Yes.
We're gonna have him do one more, and then we're gonna talk to him a little bit about the record. So if you don't mind, can you don't mind doing one more, John?
Not unless you join us.
Okay.
God's great key of G.
In the key of G. All right, ladies and gentlemen. So we're gonna do one more with Mr. John Fole, and then we'll have a word with him about this new record that he's got out. Thank you. John 4, everybody.
How about a 4?
All right, we're going. Let's bring John over to the interrogation booth and talk to him for a few minutes. In the meantime, we got Mr. J.D. Hill and the Jammers going to come up next after we talk to John. So we're going to, let's go over to this here, John. John's got a new record. Why don't you tell us a little bit about it?
Well, it's an album. It's a CD.
Yeah, man. Looks great.
Yeah, it sounds great. It came out really good. It's got a great band on it with Eric Bolivar and Cass Faulkner.
Oh, Eric on drums, man.
Johnny Sansone and Rod Hodges from the Iguanas plays accordion. And it's a killer band.
Where'd you do this record?
I did it at the Music Shed in New Orleans.
How do we know that place?
Yeah, I saw you there when I was doing overdubs.
Oh, that's right.
On this record.
That's a good sounding studio, too.
It's awesome, and Jack, well, Jack did my record. He wasn't doing yours, but he's great.
Jack Mealy?
Jack Mealy, yeah. Good dude, and, you know, yeah, there's a bunch of songs I kind of collected since my last record, which was about 4 or 5 years ago, so... Just demoed them out and made another one.
So we can talk more about the record. What the guys that you got on this, you've been playing with a long time? Do you piece them together for the record, or is it...
Yeah, I don't have a band.
Okay, so you cut... Because you do a lot of solo
bands, I go out by myself most of the time, and you know, or I play with other people's bands.
Right.
And I do, you know, every now and then I put a band together to do a gig here and there, but I don't I don't keep a band working.
But you have a steady... I know you had for like... 20 years you've had a steady gig.
Yeah, I have a steady gig
on Mondays. Solo?
Yep, that's all solo, and yeah, people come and sit in or whatever.
Yeah, so where can, and when people come to New Orleans, they can see you Monday nights?
Monday nights at Dos Jefes.
Dos Jefes.
My only regular gig, but I play everywhere.
Yeah, they see you everywhere, too. You probably, if they came during Jazz Festival, they'd probably see you 20 times.
They probably will, yes, with 20 different acts.
Tell us about, you know, what's your background with the guitar. Like, what kind of... Yeah, blues influence, obviously.
Yeah.
But what kind of guys do you like to listen to, you know?
Well, I'm from Montana, so I grew up, you know, playing, you know, whatever was popular when I was growing up, which was, you know, Montana. There, which was country and, you know, old rock and roll and, you know, blues and stuff, too. But, you know, I got into blues a little later. You know, I met a guy that I took a lesson from and told me, you know, oh, you know, you have to learn to play the blues before you can do anything else. So... I went and got into that and was lucky, you know, up in Montana at that time, I'm talking about the 80s, the 1980s. Back then, all the Chicago guys, well, they were all still alive.
Right,
for one thing, and they were all touring, and they would tour across to start the West Coast tours in Seattle or California, and they would come through Montana, so...
Montana had a place where they played.
Man, I got to hang and yeah, there was several places. There was a blues bar in where I was in college in Missoula that had blues bands 5 nights a week, and they would have the Chicago bands. They would have Jimmy Rogers 1 week, Wild Child Butler the next week,
Eddie Shawn the Wolfgang.
Yeah. They were like 3 or 4 times a year they would come through. And you know, those guys were all good friends of mine. But I got to, you know, I got to meet and play with a whole.
So were you playing at that time?
Oh,
would you sit in with these guys, with the Chicago guys?
Yeah. I got to meet and play with a bunch of those cats then, and you know, I did was in a band. You know, we backed up Bo Diddley on a tour back then, and, you know, in the mid '80s, and you know, we played with a bunch of different guys that would come through without a band too. We kind of.
It's funny because you've been in New Orleans so long. I don't think about you having a life before that.
Yeah, yeah.
So Montana, and then how did you end up right here?
I moved to Oregon.
You went to Oregon first.
Yeah, I lived there for about 10 years and was playing music there, and I was in a band called the Cherry Poppin' Daddies that had a big hit and
really,
you know, got a platinum record on my wall from that shit. And,
so you got a taste of what it's like to hit.
Well, no, they actually did all the work after I left the band. But I did get a taste because I was on the records and, you know, I was able to, you know, get that little taste together. But, you know, I was in that band and I left that band and was working up there with other bands and moved here in 96 to New Orleans.
Wow.
And, so I've been here like 22 years and, you know, gigging 300 days a year.
Now you spent some time with the 9/11 band.
Lower 9/11.
So like 10, 11 years,
11
huh?
years, yeah.
And good memories with that?
Absolutely, nothing but. Yeah.
That was a good sound.
The last maybe 6 months.
Yeah, that was a good sounding band, I think.
It was a great band. And really, it was. I know I'll. I'm pretty sure I'll never get to have that musical experience again. To have that kind of synergy with those cats. It was really, you know, because we played so much, we toured so much, and the book was so big.
Are you still? Do you still friendly with Dr. John?
You know, I haven't spoken with him in some. It's been about a year since I spoke with him.
Yeah. But you're good though.
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah, yeah. That's what I thought. I read an interview that you guys. It was amicable. You know.
It was, it was. I wouldn't call it amicable, but it was. It was time.
Yeah.
He was ready for a change. I know that.
So then you go and you did a record, your solo record a couple years ago.
Yeah.
And then you did this one. So are these the only two that you can find that are John Fole records?
I have about four.
Oh, yeah, four.
My fourth one, yeah, that I've done by myself. And,
you know. And the songs you come up with, I told you I was going to ask you, but it's just, I don't know, how do you come up with these songs?
Man, I don't know, you know, you just get a little snippet here. I'm really lucky to, you know, I get to, I play on a lot of records and I work with a lot of songwriters.
Yeah, John, I would say, John, if you guys are... want to know about New Orleans musicians, I think John Fole is one of the top session calls, I think, for guitar.
I get a lot of, you get a lot of records.
Yeah. That's, you should be really proud of that. That's really good.
A lot of TV and movie and whatnot and stuff. But so I'm really lucky in that sense. I get to work with some really great songwriters. So I feel like my songs all tend to be very short.
Right.
You know, there's only a few verses, you know, because I'm just... I can't stand drivel in a song, so I you know, it's like I just edit it out, so my songs
are qualifies as drivel.
Well, you know, my own drivel. Other people's drivel I'm fine with. It's just my own drivel that I just have to edit it out. So I end up doing, you know, I end up just with short songs and lots of guitar solos and very few lyrics. But.
And so what do we got going on now? Like, if people come to New Orleans, like, you see at Dos Cefes, and do you have any tours coming up or anything?
We got a few little trips this summer with Sandstone. We got a duo trip going to Finland. And,
that must be nice. Just two, don't France. Have to worry about the band.
Yeah, and then, you know, he's got a few things with his band, too, on the road this summer, some festivals and stuff. And
good. He was here last week.
Oh, yeah. Taylor.
Yeah, he's great.
Yeah, he's awesome.
He played really great. Yeah, it was very powerful. So we had a lot of fun with him.
Yeah, you got him, it must have been like 10 days into Lent. Ooh.
Yeah.
Yeah.
All right, well, let's see, everybody. You can check it out, the new record, Hands on You. Where can they get it? They get the Louisiana Music Factory, Amazon.
Locally, yeah, locally you can buy it in any of the record stores locally. But, on Amazon and iTunes and all the digital formats, CD Baby and everywhere digitally.
All right. Well, we want to thank you for coming in today.
You know, it's always a pleasure.
One of our favorite guys.
You know, it's going to be really fun. It's J.D. Hill.
I know. We got J.D. Hill, everybody. But one more time, this is John Fole. Make sure you check it out. Look, Johnny, website, Facebook.
Facebook.
So they can you can get hold of John on the Facebook, John Fole, F-O-H-L.
Yeah.
Check out his new record. And, John, we'll have you come in again, right?
Hope so, man. Thanks. See you soon.
All right, ladies and gents. At this time, we got one of our favorite bands. And our favorite guys. He's a legend right here in New Orleans, Mr. J.D. Hill and the Jammers. I'm going to talk to J.D. too, but we're going to let his music speak for himself first. So, everybody sit back, relax, and this is Mr. J.D. Hill and the Jammers. Thank you.
Little red rooster, been gone. hope you enjoy the music. Out there in TV land or Web City land, man, we're going to do a little something here by... yeah, we did this one earlier. Let's do this here. Okay, we're going to do something different. Okay. Thank you.
what we're missing here. Ladies and gentlemen, this is the Jammers, J.D. Hill. J.D., can you tell us, who to introduce your band, if that's all right, man, to the people out there.
Tommy Buzz Matthews on the guitar. Ricky Sears are on the drums. One of the Sears brothers. David Renson Jetson, also known as Major Bacon. All right. I'm J.D. Hill. Together we J.D. and the Jammers. And fortunate to be here playing again. Had cancer, beat it. Just can't beat the bullshit. So I hope you enjoy the music, and you can always reach us through the Musicians Union. Plus, I'm playing at Bar Redux tomorrow, Dave and I. It's right on Poland. And we have a few other gigs coming up every now and then, but if you want us, you can find us. All right.
So, J.D., we're going to play some more, but I just want to make sure that people know where they can to get a hold of you. You're on Facebook, huh?
Yeah, Facebook. So, and
what about, you have a website?
I got a Facebook website, that's about it.
Okay, no, that's good enough, though. So, people, you can check out J.D. Hill and the Jammers, or you look for the Facebook page. And when they're in New Orleans, they can see you around. They see you're at Bar Redux pretty regularly, huh?
Yeah. I play periodically with Mr. Mick, Dr. John, and Deacon John, and whoever else calls me, really.
See, that's the thing about J.D., man. He's got such a history. J.D., how long have you been here, active playing music in New Orleans?
Since 81, I believe.
That's a long time.
I've got a T-shirt back home from the Uptown Youth Center that Aaron Neville did years ago, and that's 1982.
Wow.
Yeah. Boy. So you and I played at the World's Fair.
You did?
Yeah. 84.
Man. And also with Deacon John.
Yeah.
Because I saw you with Deacon John before.
And we did Live at Tiffatina's together. That's a video. And we did a Live at the Jazz Fest. One year at the Jazz Fest. I was part of the Ivories. And well, a whole bunch of stuff like that.
Yeah, but you got quite the history. So it's a real pleasure to have you come on and bring your band. This J.D.'s the first one to bring his full band on with him, too. You know, usually the people, they sit in with the band, the house band, you know. But J.D. said, I want to bring the full band, the Jammers. So, ladies and gentlemen, when you're in New Orleans, you go up, try to look up J.D. Hill and the Jammers, and I'm going to let them get to play some more music, man.
All right.
So,
okay. All right.
J.D. We'll be right back. J.D. Hill and the Jammers. We got time for one more. Is that all right?
Yeah.
You guys do? I just want to, we'll say, we'll give our goodbyes to everybody. Everybody, you are listening to the Blues Vortex right here at Bywater Track Studios, the heart of the Bywater, beautiful New Orleans. We're live, and this is something we do every week to have some roots and blues and some fun. Don't forget, Sunday afternoons, they've got live shows right here every Sunday at 2 o'clock. That's New Orleans time. But, right now, next week on the Blues Vortex, we got Washboard Chaz, Blues Trio, and some other guests, too. But right now, I just want to say, J.D., one more time, I want to thank you for coming on and playing. And let's see, we already told them where you're playing.
This ain't regular TV. We're going to play two songs, all right?
Hey, do whatever you want, man. You know, you can get away with it, man. All right, so everybody, we'll see you next week. We're going to leave you with J.D. Hill. He's going to do a couple more for you. So, J.D. Hill and the Jammers. Thank you.
something you got, babe. Make the world all day. Something you got, baby. Make me bring on my head. Something you got, baby. Steady.